Hi guys, this is TechZact again, and in this video I would like to speak about my own laptop, which is a Lenovo T440S, which I'm using for several years now and I'm pretty satisfied with it, but it also has some drawbacks. First of all, I would like to speak about the main specs of this machine. So it has an i7 Intel processor, 12 gigs of RAM, 4R internal, and the max capacity is 12 gigs. Intel HD 4400 integrated graphics solution, 14-inch IPS Full HD display, and a Samsung SSD with capacity of 256 gigs. So let's speak about the keyboard. I personally think that it's just great. The feeling if I press the buttons are satisfying, and you can hit a big enter every time you feel you need to. It's so massive that it doesn't even care if you are rude. There's an option to see the keys in low light thanks to the globing backlight, which has two stages, a stronger and a weaker one. The keyboard has one more great feature, which is the spill resistance, which I'm not going to try out because I'm a shy little girl, so you have to believe it. Here's a video where you can hear the sound of the keys. So the next thing is the trackpad and the trackpoint, which are used to go hand in hand. The trackpoint is located in the center of the keyboard and it can be used with the three built-in buttons which are on the top of the touchpad. I personally don't really like that they are built-in because they require considerably more force than the previous ThinkPads. By the way, if you have never tried the trackpoint, I would highly recommend it because if you want to move the cursor, you don't have to move off your hand from the keyboard, you just have to move one of your fingers. The touchpad has 5 built-in buttons, which means that if you press on certain points of the touchpad, that means different clicks. With a slightly more force, you can also click the whole touchpad, which sinks about a couple of millimeters, which was really weird for the first time, but I managed to get used to it. And now, please listen carefully. Okay, let's take a look at the ports. I will start with the easiest side, which is the back side, where no ports are available because of the removable battery. Let's right jump into the right side, which has the following ports: a headphone jack, one SIM card slot, 4-in-1 memory card reader, USB 3 port, LAN port for gigabit Ethernet, VGA port for connecting to other monitors and projectors, and the Kensington lock slot, which is a pretty useful thing if you work in an office, because you don't have to put your notebook into the drawer and lock it, you just shut down and that's all. I have to put my notebook into the drawer every day, and I'll be honest with you, I'm starting to not enjoy it. Okay, that's all for the right side, now check the left side, which features the following good stuff: a power jack, USB 3 port, display port, USB 3 port, and a smart card reader, which is used at big companies for two-factor authentication. The front side of the notebook is not really exciting, it has a slightly open gap, which is really helpful if you want to open the lid. Let's take a look at the back of the notebook too. There's the removable battery, the holes where the liquid can flow out from the keyboard, the speakers, the phone, and last but not least, the dock connector. If you don't know what's docking, I'll explain it quickly. So it's a device which is pretty useful if you have to bring your laptop with yourself many times a day. This is a separate device where you can plug in a lot of cables into it, and then You just have to plug in your docking station into your notebook and everything works. For instance, I also use a docking station at my workplace because I have a lot of meetings and I need my machine there. Let me tell you something about the display and the webcam. The ThinkPad notebooks are not typically known for their high quality display, but this machine is an exception. It's a 14-inch 1080p IPS display. It is sufficiently bright, it has vibrant colors and great viewing angles. The resolution is so big that it's perfect for work or programming, because you can see the two windows on the display, one on the left side and the other one on the right side. On the upper side of the display you can find the 720p HD display, which has two noise cancelling microphones which filter out the background noise. The next thing is the build quality and the materials, which are always in the upper category at ThinkPad. It has a smooth black carbon fiber lid and the chassis made of magnesium alloy. The internal roll cage also helps the notebook to meet the mil-spec testing requirements, which is a military standard and means that it is capable to withstand extreme vibrations, temperature, shock, dust, humidity, high and low atmospheric pressure. The notebook measuring in at the following sizes and weighing in at 1.72 kilograms. It's quite small, so it fits into any normal size backpack and you can bring some other things too. It's not even that heavy, I mean, come on, 1.72 kilograms, it's like 6 big potatoes. The adapter is also small, so it doesn't take up a huge space in your backpack. There's two batteries in the notebook, one is an internal one and the other one is an external one. Both batteries are the same, they are 3-cell 24-watt-hour batteries. If you use the notebook from battery, first the external one gets drained and after that the internal one. And if you plug in your notebook, then first the internal one gets charged up and after that the external one. The notebook also has a hot swap capability, which means that you don't have to turn the notebook off and you can switch the external battery. The fan wasn't getting loud even when I was installing Fortnite, so I was satisfied with it. I have tried to make a footage about it, but the fan was more loud in the video than in the real life, so I let it go, makes no sense. To mention something about the temperature, when I was installing Fortnite, it was a little bit hot on the left upper side of the keyboard, so I think no problem at all. Let's right jump into the colors. Solid gray everywhere, only the keyboard is black. I really like it. I'd like to speak a little bit about the performance of the notebook, which I'm going to represent with two footages, where I turn the PC on from battery and when I turn it on when it's plugged in. The difference is noticeable. The best thing if you want to make a video. You just have to wait. Okay, is it finished? By the way, if you would like to use it for work, I think it's the perfect choice. I wouldn't recommend it for full HD 60fps video editing because the sound was lagging, and I wouldn't recommend it for playing games. It's a business laptop, completely adequate for work, listening to music, surfing on the web, using Photoshop, Illustrator, coding, hacking, watching movies. I have tried to play Fortnite, but if you would like to enjoy the game, you'd rather buy a PC or a gaming laptop. Thank you. little info about the audio. The laptop's bottom-mounted speakers were powerful enough to provide audio to a modest-sized room comfortably. I think that the music was clear even at 100 capacity. There's an included Dolby Audio software which made the audio quality more tolerable than it would have been without it. I have had some notebooks before and I think that the sound quality is the best in this notebook. The price is around $350, so I think it's pretty good price for the value. So that's been it, thanks for watching and see you guys in the next video. Bye!